стыдно.
Олесия Яренскилх could not hold back her tears. Her son has just received a donation of notebooks and pens because the family could not afford them. The brick factory where Яренскилх worked stopped operating in May, cutting off employees' incomes without warning.
Это дикость, потому что мои дети радуются колбасе. Когда я прихожу из города, и он радуется, говорит: «Ура, мама, у нас есть дома колбаска!»
Nearly 200 workers lost their jobs at the factory in the town of Asbest in Russia's Urals region. Negotiations over the factory's ownership are underway, but workers don't know whether it will reopen. Many have had to borrow money just to survive in the past few months.
Дети голодом сидят практически. Они зарплату не могут получить. Что это за правительство, за наше, за такое сраное? Где-то их пиродолбим, там наши самолеты летят, бомбы столько денег скидывают. Потом гуманитарка, уже 59-й конвой пошел. А вы посмотрите на лесозаводе, какие тут, блядь, дороги.
The factory is part of the Yava Corporation, headed by Valery Yazov, a member of parliament in the ruling United Russia Party. He was awarded a medal by President Vladimir Putin for merit to the fatherland. Employees have sought help from the local prosecutor's office without success. In August, they protested outside the factory, calling for Putin's help.
Владимир Владимирович, помогите!
In early September, workers went to the factory to demand their May paychecks. They were blocked from entering by armed security guards, although their May salaries were eventually paid.
Вам выдадут зарплату, и вы здесь работать уже больше не будете.
The workers' plight has been largely ignored by the media. Meanwhile, Яренскилх has received anonymous threats.
Вам кто угрожал, звонил?
А я не знаю. Скрытый номер. Ну, сказали, что мы вообще много говорим, что деньги нам, скорее всего, не понадобятся, но если только на крышку гроба.
Олеся says she's down to her last few rubles. Not even enough for tomorrow's bread. She's been left with no work, no income, and no information about what might happen next.